Hey, happy, 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 beautiful, amazing day. Dr. Bob Rutkowski here out of Houston, Texas with Work From Home Wednesday. So let's jump right in. What's our objective? I want to share solid proven strategies to grow your business from home. But let's take it a step further. We're calling it Work From Home Wednesday. I'd rather call it MMA Every Day. No, we're not going to talk about fighting, even though Conor McGregor is certainly the current picture of the MMA. MMA is going to be make money anywhere, because if you've got a smartphone, if you've got technology, if you've got a connection, you can reach out to the world. And we're going to show you how to do it in a way which is going to attract business to you. I love this quote from Maya Angelou. She said, "People will forget what you said. They will forget what you did, but they will never forget how you made them feel." So we always want to interact with people in a way that leaves them feeling better than we started. We want them to feel good about themselves. They want to feel good about our interactions. And that ultimately is the best way to grow your business. Eric Worre is the best skills trainer in the game. I've studied under many greats in network marketing, and I encourage you to do that. Find the trainer that you resonate with, but he talks about the seven skills, and we are going to go through them one by one. I'm going to quote Jim Rohn here, one of the greatest networkers of all time. He said, "Success is not something that you pursue. It is actually something that you attract by the person you become." So if you're chasing something, that whatever you're chasing tends to run away. Let's work on attracting the person we want to become, the people we want to work with, and the life that we want to build. So I'm going to quote John Maxwell here on prospecting. He says, "I've sifted through a lot of dirt in order to deliver the gold." That is just the nature of any type of prospecting. If you could get rich just by looking at the ground and picking something up, hey, the whole world would be rich. But I promise you, there's richness everywhere. There's opportunity everywhere. And the goal is to find it. I believe everybody has plenty of potential, but timing is not right for absolutely everybody. So let's just talk about one level of prospecting. So I like sporting events, and you know, you can meet a big stadium with 100,000 people, and you'll see people, you know, running around with this, "Peanuts, get your peanuts here, peanuts." You know, and what are they doing? They're just basically shouting out for anybody who wants it, anybody who's hungry at that moment. So if it's a long sporting event, let's say it takes 2 or 3 hours, you know, you might be in a different market for peanuts by the end of, you know, 2.5 hours than you were at the start. So here's the whole deal. Timing counts, and you want to expose your potential prospects to what you have, but do it in a way that's not offensive. With that said, Art Williams has a phenomenal book. It's an audio book, How to Beat Talent, Brains, and Education, every single time. And he talks about they actually sold in the network marketing model life insurance door to door. You know, and people didn't make very many sales. So they brought in a guy that made a lot of sales, and they said, "How do you do it?" Well, he did it with the law of high numbers. He was knocking on doors, and his question would be, "You don't want life insurance, do you?" And basically about 59 out of 60 people would slam the door in his face. Now, keep in mind, that violates the rule of, you know, have everybody feel better about the interaction. But ultimately, that 1 in 60 would say, "Maybe I do. What do you have?" And so if you expose enough people, you'll find enough people. But I want to be very, very cautious about how we expose people to information, because we want them to have a good impression of us. Remember, we reap what we sow. So if we are going to share good feelings, good everything, good comes back. So I was in Eric Worre's living room in January for a mastermind, and he brought up this young man. And this, I regret that I didn't write down his name, but basically he's 19 years old and he already has 5 million followers on Instagram. Now, Eric Worre said that that's an asset worth about $500,000. Why? Because if you got 5 million followers, you could probably suggest something and enough of them would take you up on it that would be significant. But they asked him how you did it. And here's what he said. He said, "You know, I had a topic that I was really passionate about, and I started sharing things daily on Instagram that literally added value." So he made it look good. He made it be good. He made it be valuable. And someone shared and someone shared and someone shared. And next thing you know, he's got a huge network of followers. Remember, your network is your net worth. So there's plenty of tools to take away. We can reach out to the world. Just do it in a way that adds value to whatever your demographic is. I love this proverb, the best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is now. So if you were building a network 20 years ago, you're probably in a good position to start essentially sharing treasures and reaping what you sow by, you know, adding value to people's lives and getting value back. But I like this strategy. Go through your phone. Probably everybody out there has a smartphone at this point. The average person has something like 250 contacts in their smartphone. Pick two A's, two B's, two C's, all the way through Z. You're probably going to come up with something like 50 people. Look at your last 10 text messages. We're going to make a list of those 50 plus these 10, plus your last 10 calls that you made and last 10 calls that you missed. That's another 20 people on your list. And your last 10 personal emails, you've got a pretty good list of people to reach out to. And in order to start today, why not text 100 people today? This would be the prospecting. Now, why do I say text? In my world, that is what gets the best response. I don't respond instantly to Facebook Messenger messages. I don't respond to emails almost at all. I don't answer my phone, but text, I kind of do that. And I think most of the world has that mindset at this point. But you want to be more personable, but this is a generic. Hi, Sally. Use their name, not hello, I was looking through my phone when I saw your name and inspired to check in. Use their name. Remember, Dale Carnegie said, person's name is the sweetest sound in any language. But hi, Sally, I was looking through my phone when I saw your name and I was inspired to check in. How are you? How is everything in your neighborhood? Very, very simple. You're not selling anything. You're making a connection. And that is what we're going to talk about when it comes to inviting. It starts with a connection. No connection, no invitation. I like the acronym CALLS, C-A-L-L-S. C is connection, make that first. A is ask questions. The L, and I got a double L there, we want to listen, and you really want to listen. Listen to what the person's telling you and tell stories. Now, too many people, when they ask a question, they're already thinking of their next reply, no matter what the person says. Don't do that. Genuinely listen, pay attention, and you really don't need to have any conversation when you're listening. You know, they might say, they start a story and then you go, interesting. Tell me more. Wow. And then, wow, right? So it doesn't take a huge vocabulary to be a good listener. Now, what kind of story are you going to tell? Whatever that conversation leads to in a way that you can add value to the person. Remember, stories are the way to go. Maybe it's an organo story. Maybe it's a travel story. Maybe it's a skincare story. Maybe it's a story about something else. You know what? I literally just had a plumber come in and he was honest and awesome and he helped me a lot. And maybe he could help you, right? When you add value to people, value comes back. So please add value to where they are. Now, the third skill is presentation. From TED, they say, thou shall tell stories. It's the biggest and best way to communicate ever. I was listening to a presentation seminar yesterday by a guy named Pete Vargas. And Eric Worre has it. Go to networkmarketingpro.com and look at the replay, because this guy is a phenomenal trainer. He started out network marketing, and he said that network marketing has some really bad stigmas. And he calls them the three C's that you shouldn't do. He says, don't be cheesy, don't be cocky, don't be cashy or flashy. Cheesy just looks cheap. Cocky or overconfident, you know, that's really not welcome. You want to be confident, but not overconfident. You want to know what you have. You want to know that it's good. But there are plenty of people that basically they're so confident, they go, look, if you don't get this, you're stupid. Well, I didn't get it right away. I don't consider myself stupid. I needed to look a little deeper. And by the way, I said no to network marketing for 40 years. Why? Because people were cheesy, they were cocky, they were flashy. When I had a good, genuine invitation, guess what? I built a really nice network. But Pete Vargas says this, make a heart-to-heart connection. Tell your story, share your why. And then they talk about something about story envy. So understand that, you know, some people might say, well, gee, I really don't like my why. Okay, get a deeper one. You know, listen, if you're struggling and you're barely keeping your head above water, that's a pretty big why. Share it from that position. Say, you know, at this point in my life, I've just had it. I've had enough. I had enough with not being able to pay the bills. And I see a way out. You know, I see that there are people that are helping people around the world, and they're going to help me become better at doing that. And I know that we have great products and great services. And I that's what I want to do for now. Now, if your why is your children, man, that I can't think of a much better why than that. But what about your parents? What if your parents are aging and you want to help them out? Or what if you have a cause that you like, you know, to make the world better? Whatever it is, I promise you, if you can really get into that why, that's where you want to start. Then the next step is the head. You share the facts. Then the hands are a call to action. And then you come back to the heart. You start with the heart. You finish with the heart. Watch the replay. It's an epic way to tell your story. What about the follow-up? I don't know if Eric Worre said this first, but I heard him say it. He said, all business is a conversation. So if you keep the conversation alive, you keep the business alive. So what are you looking for in a follow-up? Well, we're looking for a customer, we're looking for a partner, or we're looking for a referral. You know, it could be actually very, very simple. You know, John, listen, you really don't have to do anything with what I shared, but what did you like most? You know, and they might say, wow, I like that this could help make my life better. I like that there's a potential business opportunity. You know, what do you think is the next best step for you? You know, and I like to leave it at that. And then when they say, you know, tell me more about getting started. Hey, there's a special now in the US, $9.95, normally $50, gives you wholesale access, gives you a website in 36 countries, you're ready to go. Now, if they don't want to be a partner, they want to be a customer, that's awesome. We love our customers. Remember, businesses without customers are not in business. And what if neither is right for them at the moment because of what's going on? If you have made a good connection, if you have good rapport, and if you added value, then you're in a position to receive a referral. So just say, John, I know timing isn't right for you. I'm building, I'm sharing. Do you know someone I can help? Can you give me just one name? Now that just one name is very, very critical. There's a trainer named Philip M. Jones. And he says, look, you know, do you have any friends? Well, yeah, I have a lot of friends. Who are you going to think of? Can you give me one name? Just one name. It simplifies the process. And then make that introduction. Reach out to the friend with a referral. Now, then there's this thing called taprooting, right? I've done it before. Okay, Bill, I know this is not right for you. Do you know anybody? Well, yeah, actually, my friend John would be awesome at this. You go reach out to John. John and you hit it off. John says, wow, I want to get started. What do? I go back to Bill and I say, hey, Bill, awesome referral for John. He's ready to get started. Yeah, I got one question for you. Do you want me to sign him up and then I'll make all the money that he, you know, off of the network that he builds? Or do you want to jump in and sign him up? Well, guess what? More often than not, they're going to jump in and sign him up. Number five, I like building belief. It used to be overcoming objections. No, I want to build belief. Eric Worre said, if I had to do it over again, I would believe bigger, faster. That's the same response from a survey from Fortune 100 CEOs. We know that belief is magic. When you absolutely believe in something, you're a lot more likely to make it happen. If you don't believe, you're not going to make it happen. So here's a simple story there. You know, if someone says, look, I'll give you $5 billion, you know, if you go over and you pick up that house and you move it 10 feet, well, you're not even going to try. Why? Because you don't believe it's possible. You know, but when you not only believe, but know, well, guess what? You believe, you act very, very differently. If someone doesn't believe, they don't even attempt. So what are the two objections that people have to getting started? They either don't believe in themselves or they don't believe in what we are offering. It literally sounds too good to be true. How do we build belief in the industry? Rise of the Entrepreneur. This is a fantastic documentary. about 25 global leaders talking about their impression of network marketing. Many of them are not network marketers. They're opinion leaders, business leaders from around the world. And what's the next part to that? What if they don't believe in themselves? Jim Rohn said this, my mentor said, let's do it, not you go do it. Let's do it. So if someone doesn't believe in themselves, okay, fine. We can bring them along until they do. But for now, let's you and I work together. Let's you and I do a three-way call with Mary. Let's you and I do whatever. And I promise you, the power of the team is so much more powerful. What about starting strong? Well, here's how I like to start strong. Okay, let's go. Let's text 100 people today. You will know that people are serious if they're willing to text 100 people a day. Now, there's a fact that if people make a little money right away, they're much more likely to stay in the business. I had a struggling team member, and I reached out to her and I said, you know what? If you can sell one sachet of coffee today, just one, I don't care if it's black, latte, mocha, whatever, I will give you a $20 bonus. Well, guess what? I got a message back a half hour later. Hey, I sold it. Were you serious? Yeah, I'm serious. Here's your 20 bucks. Now, why would I do that? Because it's someone that really needed it. They needed to know that they could do it. The 20 bucks was going to help them, you know, through a tough time. And so now, if you can sell one, guess what? You can sell two. If you can sell two, you can sell three. If you can sell three, you can sell 10. If you can sell 10, you can build a massive business. But go back to conversations of success. Joshua Campbell, when he started in Jamaica, Kingston, Jamaica, he literally sold and made over $500 in 2 weeks, which was big money in Jamaica. If you want to build belief in what we're having, watch Rise of the Entrepreneur. That is going to tell you why our industry is so solid, and watch Fantastic Fungi. Can people do all those in one day? I promise you they can. Will it be time well spent? Absolutely. Then we build from there. One of my favorite things to do is to find an accountability, find a running buddy, someone that is going to push you. You know, and too often people pick accountability partners, you know, that are not going to succeed like they're not going to succeed, right? I remember Tony Robbins talking, you know, to a group of people one time that wanted to lose weight. He says, look, all of you need to lose weight. You may not be the best accountability partner because one of you says, yeah, let's skip the workout and go have, you know, a piece of birthday cake. No, that doesn't work. Find someone who has what you want that's willing to run with you. If you don't know one, maybe the person that sponsored you can assign one. But get an accountability partner and run together. So I like this quote, you want to change your day, not your life. Why? Life is a big thing and it's way off in the future, most of it, right? But your day, that's here, that's now. Change your day, then you'll change your life. So what are the first thing we want to do is we want to be a walking billboard for Organo. We want to have that beautiful skin. We want to have that beautiful smile. We want to have the energy that our healthy coffee and tea gives. We want to have the body composition of a shake that's awesome for weight management. And then we want to know how good Travala is. Not just for traveling the world, but so many of the ancillary things, and you're going to find more out about that on Travel Thursday or Travala Thursday. But number two, earn the right to make a recommendation to someone every single day, and that comes with connecting, that comes with asking questions, that comes with listening, that comes with telling stories. I personally like to talk to people. I like to go face to face with people. You can do FaceTime, you can do Zoom. I promise you that's a lot more powerful than texting back and forth. Then we want to share our new paradigm. You know, network marketing has a black eye and it's well-deserved because of cheesy, because of cocky, because of flashy cashy. But we have a new paradigm where everybody wins. Everybody in the ecosystem, from every supplier to every distribution partner to every customer to everybody in corporate to everybody everywhere. When everybody wins, that's a beautiful thing. And then finally, learn the power of live events and support live events, because that's where the money is and that's where skill seven comes in. So Don King, pretty famous guy, a master promoter. This guy has made more money than nearly any boxer that ever stepped in the ring, and he never, ever, ever took a punch. When I was with Eric Worre in his living room, you know, this is what he has said for years. You'll get about $1,000 income for every person you get to a major event. Well, I promise you that Organo for our team is a lot higher than that. So we have always strived. We were told, look, you get 100 people to a major event, you go diamond. Well, we did it. And believe it or not, the first time we crossed 100 people at a major event, we went diamond. How awesome is that? Now, the world is a little bit down on major events, at least live, but there's plenty of online. There's plenty every single week. But what about Eric Worre's recruiting mastery in December? Ultimately, I think corporate's going to make an announcement about having a partnership where they're going to make tickets available, although don't quote me on that. I'm just planting a seed there. Our team made a huge investment in tickets, and ours are almost already sold out. So I promise you, people that put people in front of good training, good people, build belief, that's the best way and the most leveraged way to make money in this business. So let's go back. People are going to forget what you said. They'll forget what you did, but they'll never forget how they made you feel. So please concentrate on adding good feelings to everybody every time. Share a smile, share warmth, share hope. It's especially needed now. And remember, we don't chase success. If we chase success, success runs from us. We attract it by the type of person that we become. Jim Rohn said, just simply become more attractive. Well, what's more attractive? How about good energy? How about a good smile? How about positivity? Those are all things that are very, very attractive. So this has been Work From Home Wednesday, and I'm Dr. Bob Rutkowski, absolutely knowing that we can all be happy, healthy, and successful.